गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ अभिषेक शर्मा फ्रॉम माउंट लिटर जी स्कूल झांसी। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद सेकेंडरी डेटा। नाउ व्हाट आर द सोर्सेज ऑफ कलेक्टिंग सेकेंडरी डेटा? बेसिकली देर आर टू सोर्सेज अवेलेबल, फर्स्ट इज पब्लिश्ड एंड अदर वन इज अनपब्लिश्ड। सो टॉकिंग टू फर्स्ट पब्लिश्ड, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद गवर्नमेंट पब्लिकेशन। मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इन इंडिया पब्लिश अ वेराइटी ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स as their routine activity. As these are published by the government, data are fairly reliable. Second is semi-government publications. Semi-government bodies like municipalities, metropolitan council publish data relating to education, health, birth and death. Third is reports of committee and commissions. Committees and commission appointed by the government also furnish lots of statistical information in their reports. Finance Commission, Monopolies Commission, Planning Commission are some of the notable commission in India which supply detailed statistical information in their reports. Now, publication of trade association. Some of big trade associations through their statistical and research division collect and publish data on various aspects of trading activity. Like we can say sugar mill association publish information regarding the sugar mills in India. Next is publication of research institution. So in this context, various universities and research institutions publish information as findings of their research activities in India. We can take example Indian Statistical Institute. National Council of Applied Economic Research published a variety of statistical data as a regular feature. Now, journals and papers. Many magazines, newspapers such as the Economic Times as well as magazines such as Commerce Facts for You also supply a large variety of statistical information. Then comes publication of research scholar. Individual also conduct their research. And individual research scholars also sometimes publish their research work containing some useful statistical information for various upcoming researcher and society. Now, there comes international publication. Many international bodies, organizations like UNO, IMF, World Bank, ILO, UNESCO, UNICEF and foreign government also publish a lots of statistical information. These are used as a secondary data for investigations. Now, what is unpublished sources? There are some unpublished secondary data as well. These data are collected by the government organization and others, generally for their self-use or for office record. These data are not published. These unpublished numerical information may however be used as secondary data. Now, what precaution we should use in secondary data? We know that secondary data are collected by others to suit their specific requirement. Therefore, one needs to be very careful and specific while using these data. Connor has rightly said, statistics, especially other people's statistics, are full of pitfalls for the users. Some of the notable questions to the bone in the mind while dealing with the secondary data are whether the data are reliable, whether the data are suitable for the purpose of inquiry or not, whether the data are adequate, sufficient for the concerned investigation which is going to be conducted. In order to assess the reliability, suitability and adequacy of the data, the following points must be kept in mind: time, definition of the unit, accuracy, objective and scope, method of collection, and finally availability of collecting the organization. One should check the availability of the organization which initially collected the data. The data should be used only if it is collected by able, experienced and impartial investigators. That data can be trusted and relied. So students, that's all for today. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे।